There is so much hype around AI right now. You can't like get away from the news for it.
I can write this paper in half the time. I could generate this picture and give me all sorts of new ideas.
How do we get started with AI?
Well, if you're just getting started, I would start with some good industry-wide practices. I think that's part of the benefits of OpenShift AI is you're going to start off with a great flow from beginning, from the data scientist, the MLOps person, all the way to the developer, and you're going to be able to take that all the way through. So make sure you're starting with a good process that is just standard, and open source is a great place to do that as well. In addition, there's a ton of open source models you can start with. If you just go to Hugging Face and look for them, you'll be able to download them and get started right away. You'll be able to develop them, be able to tune them, be able to serve them. And once you're really comfortable with your model and you really want to get into it and you've gotten that progression, go ahead and you're going to start fine-tuning it or creating your own model then.
Awesome. So what are some of the use cases?
Oh my gosh, everything from object detection, text generation, image generation, you know, anything where you're just labeling something or generating something that real algorithms could not do, right? If you can't write a program to if else your way to a solution, AI is usually kind of where, you know, it sits.
Okay, so who are the personas behind this? Who cares about AI?
Well, so it is a complex problem, right? Because it starts with the data scientist, but you know the world is littered with data science projects that never left the notebook. You get a notebook no one else can read, and you know you spend a bunch of money. So you definitely want to get value out of that. So it starts with the data scientist. It moves to an ops person, like an ML ops person, DevOps, and then it goes on to the developer. You have to go through that whole sequence, right? So let's go ahead and start developing that model for the data scientist. Let's give that over to a ML ops person to standardize and register those models and take care and automate everything about it. Then go ahead and serve it and monitor those models in production to make sure they're performing correctly and know when that you're going to need to fine tune or retrain those models.
So why is AI so complex?
Part of it is just that it's new, right? There's a lot of great use cases and a lot of hype around it, but like the tooling is just getting there. So we're coming up to those standards now, and that's what we're trying to, you know, solve for our customers. But it is a new set of problems. It's different from regular application development. You know, data science is, again, there's a lot of it is you may not be changing the algorithm for the model or the code itself. It's just the data that you trained on, right? So that's one change. The computational requirements around training these models is very high. It's not just a normal build, right? You're going to distribute your training job across multiple GPUs for, you know, perhaps a long time. So that's new. And then in addition for like serving models, it's not just your normal set of metrics. You've got to know if your model is performing correctly, if it's drifting, if there's bias, all kinds of things. It's a great place to start is regular app dev, you know, procedures, but then you've got an additional layer of AI stuff on top.